it's something that, first let us talk something about food. Have you all had your breakfast in the morning?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, okay. No, ma'am. Good. Ma'am. Then, okay, now, is Chaitanya there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Chaitanya, can you see my screen, the PPT?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you read it from the title itself?
School meal diet on school days. 7:30 a.m.
There is a pause in between. There is a hyphen in between. Read it. School meal diet on school days. Okay.
School meal diet on school days.
Okay.
7:30 a.m. Milk slash light breakfast. 10 a.m.
Milk breakfast or light breakfast.
Okay. Or 12 p.m. lunch. 2:45 p.m. bus snacks. 4 p.m. whatever available at home. 9 p.m.
whatever dinner. What all available at home? Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Finished. 9 p.m. dinner finished.
Ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you feel it's right? At least 75%. Is this the diet that you follow during your school days?
No, ma'am.
No, no. More than this.
Yes, ma'am.
Not even this.
Less,
not
I'm
even
lesser
this.
Than this.
Okay, okay. That's why I asked them. Is it correct? At least 75%. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So now, if you are following this, this we can call as a balanced diet. Okay, you are following a balanced diet. This is what is called aging. Okay, next. Is Pranav there?
Yes, ma'am.
Pranav, can you read this?
Yes, ma'am.
From the title itself. Oh.
School meal diet on homeschooling days. 8 a.m. milk plus light breakfast. 8:30 a.m. splendid continental breakfast plus snacks or milk. 11:30 a.m. class over. What is for lunch? 11:40 a.m. something before lunch gets ready. 12:45 a.m. appetizer. 1 p.m. a 3-course meal. 3 p.m. some bites to eat. 4 p.m. something to munch and drink. 7 p.m. snacks pre-dinner. 9 p.m. dinner. 10 p.m. cereals or smoothies just to sleep.
Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I right?
I'm like sumo wrestler.
Sorry? Too much.
Sumo wrestler's diet.
Is it Amoga
diet? I'm only in case of.
Is it too much for Amoga? Okay. But I think I have chosen a proper, a right person to read this.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So now you can see the difference between the previous slide and this slide, right? The previous slide, we can call it as that is eating habit, right? A proper balanced eating habit. But this one, what can we call it? Can we call it overeating? Yeah. Can we call it overeating?
Yes, ma'am.
Somebody said, yes, I think Amoga, somebody said it is overeating. Fine. This, of course, is overeating. Right? And now, with this overeating, with this diet, and now especially due to corona, you people are not going outdoor to play also. Right? Consequently, what will happen?
Obesity.
What happen? You all become?
Fat.
Fat. Obese. Okay. And okay. And another thing, so that's a consequence of overeating and not having any exercises, right? And what make you to eat more? That is, you have a greed for food, right? And you have plenty of time, no work at all, and you can't resist at food, right? By seeing food, if you like the food, you can't resist at it, right? So now, but consequently, what will happen? It will become fat. Now, Goya, we are going to see a character, okay, who has done all these things, who overeats, or we can say overfeeds, who was overfed and has no exercises at all, and what was the consequence? And was he cured? If he's cured, in what way? That's what we are going to see, right? So now see, this is the chapter name, The Triumph of Surgery, written by James Alfred Wright, okay? And his pen name or pseudonym name is James Harriet. Actually, he was a veterinary doctor by profession. You all know what is a veterinary doctor, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. A person who treats the animals, right? So now nowadays we call short vet. We don't used to call veterinary surgeon. We call vet. Okay. So as we used to call the person vet, we often tend to forget the spelling. So I want you to note down the spelling of veterinary. It is veterinary. Okay. So I have highlighted it in red. See that? V-E-T-R-I-N-A-R-Y. Generally, people tend to forget that R-I in between. Okay? So that is the spelling of veterinary surgeon. Now, and now here in this book, he has explained about his experience. But maybe added some flavors onto it. Okay, it is not given in the form as it is. He is so many of his stories were dealing with the cases that he had dealt with. So, as he used to give some characters or some real life instances from, so that's the reason most of his stories are classified as semi autobiographical stories or semi autobiographical works. Do you understand what is semi autobiographical? The difference between autobiographical and semi-autobiographical. Autobiographical means a person writing everything about a person himself, right? From the birth, his brought up and the sexes, his accomplishments, all things will be covered in autobiography. But what is semi-autobiography is you are concentrating on a particular an instance, okay? And then you are just talking about it, adding some flavors to it. That's what we call. Only if you're focusing on a particular part of your life and then you're writing about it, it's called semi-autobiographical. Okay. Now, we go to the... So, here we have... Yeah. Is there anybody having any questions? Now, here in this lesson, we have three characters. Okay. One is Dr. Harriet, author, as well as the narrator, who is the vet, the veterinary surgeon, and Mrs. Pumphrey. She's a rich mistress and she owns a dog. The dog's name is Tricky. Okay, these are the three characters. Now let us see who is suffering due to overeating. Which character? Okay, and can you guess? Give any guesses? Who overeat?
Mom, the dog.
Yeah, the dog. You might have read the story before.
Mom, the dog.
Yeah, the dog.
Mom, not given in the image.
In the image also, very good. So now these are the characters. And next, theme. As generally we used to discuss about a theme, let's come to that last after I finish explanation of it and you all have to find out what is the theme. Okay, as usual. Okay. Now, so hope you're all ready with that. I'll go to the text. Yes, wait. With the first page. Go to the first page.
Sonny ma'am, can you tell everyone to mute? Ma'am?
Sorry?
Can you tell everyone to mute their mics?
Okay, Chilan, can you mute yourself? And if you have any questions, you can unmute. Now, the lesson, the first page, a triumph of surgery. First, let us see the significance or the explanation of the title. Later, after you know the story, you have to connect. You have to give me the significance of the title. A triumph. What do you mean by a triumph? That is success. Okay? Triumph of surgery. So here, surgery, we can't limit the word surgery only to medical terms, right? So we can take it the synonym of surgery as an operation also. Operation, again, we can't restrict the term to a medical term, right? It is not only the operation, the real surgery, what a doctor performs. Generally, we call an operation, what is a plan for execution, right? So here you can take that word operation in that sense as well. So that here also it is didactic in meaning. You know the meaning of didactic, I hope, right? I'll go further. I was really worried about Tricky this time. I had pulled up my car when I saw him in street with his mistress, and I was shocked at his appearance. He had become hugely fat, like a bloated sausage with a leg at each corner. His eyes, bloodshot and rheumy, stared straight ahead, and his tongue lolled from his jaws. I want all of you to mark this passage. This is the description of Tricky, the present condition of Tricky when the narrator sees up. Mark it. I'll go further. Mrs. Pumphrey, hasn't you explained? He was so listless, Mr. Harriet. He seemed to have no energy. I thought he must be suffering from malnutrition. So I have been giving him some little extras between meals to build him up, some malt and cod liver oil, and a bowl of Horlicks at night to make him sleep. Nothing much, really. And did you cut down on this, the sweet things as I told you? Oh, I did for a bit, but he seemed to be so weak, I had to relent. He does love green cakes and chocolates, so I can't bear to refuse him. I looked down again at the little dog. That was the trouble. Tricky's only fault was his greed. Children, can you mark that line as well? Tricky's only fault was greed. From there to till the end of the paragraph. He had never been known to refuse food. He would tackle a meal at any hour of the day or night. And I wondered about all the things Mrs. Pumphrey hadn't mentioned. Here means he's talking about, she mentioned a few food items, right? So just he's wondering about what are the other things she has been giving to that dog to make it further ill. Are you giving him plenty of exercise? Well, he has his little walks with me, as you can see. But Horkin, the gardener, has been down with lumbago. So there has been no right ring throwing lately. Now, I finish the first page reading. Now, let us see the explanation of it. Okay. So here, the first page itself is giving you the introduction of all the three characters of the story. As I told you, Tricky, the main character, is introduced, Pumphrey, and the mistress is introduced, and Dr. Harriet. So here it's a meeting. And from this meeting, Sudesh, can you unmute yourself?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Sudesh, I want you to answer for this question. So from this page, from this, whatever explained in this page, do you feel that this is the first meeting between Mrs. Pumphrey and the doctor?
Is no, ma'am.
They're already known to each other. Okay. And Dr. Harriet already, he knew about the dog, right? And he knew about the problem of the dog also. What's the problem of the dog?
Ma'am, he's eating too much and there's lack of exercise.
Yeah, why is he eating too much? I told you to mark one paragraph, right, as an extract, the second one.
Greed.
Ma'am, the owner was giving him too much food and he was greedy.
And his greed. And if you, as I told you to mark the second paragraph, children, this is one of the questions which had come in the current, I mean, the recent board examination. What is the major problem of Tricky? Okay. And so here, what is the major flaw in Tricky? Major flaw in Tricky, not the problem of Tricky. If it is asked, what's the problem of Tricky? Then you can say that it, it has been fed with a lot of food and it has become hugely fat. But here, what's the problem? What's the flaw in Tricky? Here, the flaw in Tricky is greed. Okay, note that point. This is one of the criteria, okay, the characteristic traits that we have to note down. Fine. You can unmute yourself. Sorry, you can mute yourself, Sudesh. So now from this page itself, we can understand that this is not the first meeting, and we are, so here we are introduced with the problem itself. As you all know, generally how we used to draw the storyline, the storyboard, whenever we discuss about the plot construction of a story, right? The triangle thing. So here the story is not starting with a good note. Already the story is starting with a problem. The problem has been introduced first itself, the beginning of the story itself. Okay? And as you can note, who is the narrator of the story? It's a first person narrative. And the doctor himself is the narrator of the story, right? So it's a first person narrative, and it is starting with a problem. So already problem is introduced. So it is very long journey to reach the climax, maybe reach the real problem, maybe. Okay. And now, and we are left with other clues that the doctor knew Tricky already. Doctor knew more about Tricky. And other thing what we have to note here is, has already given some warnings about Tricky to Mrs. Pumphrey. Okay. Has known about Mrs. Pumphrey's way of overfeeding it. So he has already warned about what are the main things. According to this page, he has warned us to reduce the speed. Okay, and to give plenty of exercises. Was that being followed by her? No, right? She was not following that. So that what was introduced in this page itself. So now, anyhow, so the doctor is not very happy. And now here another thing is mentioned. So now both the people, Mrs. Pumphrey as well as the doctor, they both are concerned about the dog. But in really different terms. Mrs. Pumphrey is concerned about the dog, telling that it is not eating properly. According to her, whatever he is having, Mr. Tricky is having is not enough. She is not happy with that. Okay, in that way she is concerned about. And in what way Dr. Harriet is concerned about us, about his health. If it continues like this, what would be the consequence? He will fall sick soon. That is what he knows. That as a doctor, he knows that very well. Shall we go to the second page? I am going to the second page. So on the first page, I asked you to mark two extracts. I tried to sound severe. So here I again with the narrator, Dr. Harriet. Now I really mean this. If you don't cut his food right down and give him more exercises, he is going to be really ill. You must harden your heart and keep him on a very strict diet. Mrs. Pumphrey wrung his hands. Oh, I will, Mr. Harriet. I'm sure you're right, but it is so difficult. Yes, Prerna, we have any doubt?
In the previous page, what is the meaning of lumbago in the second last line?
What's the meaning of?
The previous page.
What's the meaning of?
Lumbago something.
Lumbago. It has to be pronounced as lumbago. Lumbago means severe muscle pain or something. Or pain on the muscles. Lumbago.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Mrs. Pumphrey wrung her hands. So no, do you know the meaning of wrung her hands? Like we... Yeah, I'll do. Doing like this. Okay. Wrung her hand. Oh, I will, Mr. Harriet. I'm sure you are right. But it is so difficult. So very difficult. She set off. Head down along the road. As if determined to put the new regime into practice immediately. I watched their progress with growing concern. Tricky was tottering along in his little tweed coat. He had a whole wardrobe of these coats for the cold weather and a raincoat for the wet days. He struggled on, drooping in his... Raincoat for the wet days. He struggled on, drooping in his hands. I thought it wouldn't be long before I heard from Mrs. Pumphrey. The expected call came within a few days. Mrs. Pumphrey was distraught. Tricky would eat nothing, refused even his favorite dishes. And besides, he had bouts of vomiting. He spent all his time lying on a rug, panting, did not want to go for walks, did not want to do anything. I had made my plans in advance. The only way was to get Tricky out of the house for a period. Can you mark this? I had made my plans in advance and till from there to under observation. Okay. I suggested that he be hospitalized for about a fortnight to be kept under observation. The poor lady almost swooned. She was sure he would pine and die if he did not see her every day. But I took a firm line. Tricky was very ill, and this was the only way to save him. In fact, I thought it best to take him without delay. So now let us see this the page, explanation of the page. So now the doctor, he knows that what would be the consequence. So he has left with another warning. Previously also he had warned to reduce the food, sweets, food, and to give plenty of exercises, but she has not followed that. And now again, before they patch on that day's meeting, so it was again warning that, see, you have to give, now it is really very serious. You have to reduce the food what you're giving, and you have to give him more exercises, or it's going to affect him very seriously. Okay, so with that warning, they depart on that day. And so now, what was Mrs. Q? Now, children, you can unmute yourself. I have some a few questions. So now, what is Mrs. Q-Frey's reaction on it? Reaction on the warning of the doctor. Is Deval there? Deval, can you answer? What was her reaction? Has she taken it positively?
Yes, ma'am. Sure. She told she'll from now on start doing his exercise and be determined to.
She told that she'll practice it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Very good. And so she was very determined that she will practice it. And now, so I watched their progress with growing concern. Can you tell me why that word "growing concern" is given? Is Vaibhavi there? Is Vaibhavi there? Or Pius, you can reply.
Now, what is the question again?
What's the meaning of the term? I watched their progress with growing concern. What's the reason for that growing concern? Growing concern. Who is concerned here?
The doctor. I'm sorry. Something's wrong with my mic.
It's fine, my baby. So, yeah. Growing concern. What's the reason for that growing concern, I'm asking?
Ma'am, because...
Is my baby answering? Others, please mute
yourself.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, she says that it's very hard to follow the new regime. Miss Pomfrey, she says that it's very hard for her to follow the new regime for Tricky. So the doctor is concerned about Tricky's health, because if they don't follow the regime, her health is at risk.
Yeah, true. So he is very concerned. As I told you previously, when I explained the previous page itself, they both are concerned, but in different ways. Okay, the doctor is very concerned that soon it is going to fall ill. Okay, so now, and now a question to Soham. Is Soham there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Soham, can you explain about, so there are a few terms given that we can use for the character sketch of Mrs. Pionfrey. Okay. So can you say what are they? Like, if you are not using the terms exactly, can you say what are the, like overall, what are the explanation given about Mrs. Pumphrey? Her affection or attachment towards the dog?
Ma'am, she thinks that the dog is her own child, and then she doesn't want him to feel like okay. She can't she can't say she can't refuse to whatever the dog wants. So then
correct. Next question is to Suraj. Is Suraj there?
Yes, ma'am.
Suraj, can you explain the luxuries that Tricky has been enjoying at Mrs. Pumphrey's house? There are a few lines given in the luxuries. Yeah.
She's been giving a lot of variety of dishes and all.
Can you be louder? Yeah.
No, 1 second. Yes, ma'am. She's been giving a lot of variety of dishes, and then she's been very lenient towards him. As in
the same paragraph itself, it's given. I watched her progress there itself. So the luxury is what he has been enjoying. Whole wardrobe of coats
for different brothers, right?
And different beds. That's all coming in the next page. So here in this paragraph, you can understand. So after that meeting, actually he was very much worried about the dog Tricky. And as expected, one day a call had come from Mrs. Pumphrey, telling that it is very ill. So what is ill now? Why she is very much worried about it is, it's not taking any food. It stops taking food. And it is not moving at all. And apart from that, even if it is a favorite dish also, it refuses it. And apart from that, he had bouts of vomiting also. Okay. So now that is the problem. Actually, this is what he was expecting also. He'll seriously fall ill very soon. So bouts of vomiting also. So now this is what he heard from Mrs. Pumphrey. And so now he has to take a serious step. So what is the step he is taking? That is the real thing. So now I had made my plans in advance. So what is that plan? So as I told you, the plan is he wants to take Tricky out. He wants to take Tricky out, okay, out of the house. Otherwise, his plans will not work out. So what are the plans? He has some plans to do. That's what I told you. The title itself, The Triumph of Surgery. The Triumph of Surgery, here it is, operation. Surgery, you can take as anonymous operation. What do you mean by operation? So now his plan, the plan that he wants to execute is that the first thing is he wants to take Tricky out of Mrs. Pumphrey's control, and then he has to give some treatment. Otherwise, if it is under the control, if he is going to the home every day, and then if he is giving the treatment, he can't do whatever he wished to. Excuse me. He can't do the treatment, whatever he wishes to do, right? So first thing, he wanted to take Tricky out of the home. Okay, so that's what the plan is. He said that. So the illness is very serious. Okay, so he has to be hospitalized for a fortnight, 15 days at least. Okay, that is what his plan is. So he has told that, and he has to keep under observation. Now, the first step of operation, okay, the executed the first step of operation, that he is going to take Tricky out of home so that the dominance of her can be totally taken away. Okay, so that is, he can stop her giving more food and not giving exercise.